kaso naman kay GNC, lanak ang pantunan eh.
And I can tell you that GNC does not lose its integrity.
GNC gave me a vision. GNC gave me that inspiration, and GNC gave me that confidence to be an effective leader.
I do believe that this is the best, if not one of the best schools here in Guagua.
GNC is really committed on providing quality education to its students, because I am a living witness to that, because I experienced quality education inside the four walls of GNC.
Isa sa mga natutunan ko is to become excellent as always. Sometimes sabi nila yung pagiging competitive negative eh. Pero isa ito sa mga binigay na spirit ng GNC sa akin. To be competitive, to be excellent in all things that you can do, no?
Sa tingin ko, bakit ako magtagal sa GNC? It's probably I really love the profession. I became who I am now, it's because of GNC. It has given me a lot of opportunities.
Sila yung nagbigay motivasyon sa akin. Sa kanila din ako kumuha ng inspirasyon kung bakit ako naging guru ngayon, yung profession ko ngayon. Na nagagamit ko nung nakita ko sa kanila yung kanilang pagmamahal sa trabaho, yung dedikasyon, na nagamit ko ngayon sa pagiging guru ko.
Nagtagal ako sa GNC, labat ako ng 28 years kasi nakita ko doon na marami akong bagay na pwedeng matutunan.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the much-anticipated celebration of our 104th GNC founding anniversary with the theme GNC Alakang Kupas Nanumang Panahon Ing Lumabas. You are witnessing the coronation night of Fides, faith in God and oneself, Sensha, search for truth and knowledge, and Patria, love for a country. Let's all witness our entourage led by our muses of the academic year 2021 to 2022. Miss Patria 2021, Robin Summer Shania F. Saliman. Miss Sensha 2021, Kimberly Nicole S. Torres. Miss Fides 2021, Gina Rose Z. Papio. Following them are our teachers, employees, the 104th Foundation Anniversary Working Committee, the Board of Administrators. Friends, ladies and gentlemen, let's all make way for our lovely muses of today's event. Miss Patria 2022, Angela Shea Silvestre E. Salvador. Approaching the center stage now is our Miss Shensha 2022, Aaron Jazil De Leon E. Swing. Let's all give way to our 2022 Miss Fides, Alisa May Narvaja E. Manala. The muses for the year 2021 to 2022 are followed by our guests, Dr. Sherwin Joseph P. Sarmiento and Dr. Gil Francis S. Pelayo, together with our school president, Trustee Geraldine Gilim, MBA, and our Head of the Instruction Cluster, Dr. Merlita C. Rizon. Mr. Alfonso M. Tordera, faculty from the College of Arts and Sciences and Education, will express our gratitude to our Lord Almighty. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Heavenly Father, we praise and thank Thee for gathering each and every one of us today. Thank You for Your guidance and blessing so that we can enjoy the meaning and significance of this event in our lives. Lord, You are the source of all goodness and graces, the cause of wisdom, and the fountain of intelligence and beauty. Lord, thank You for the gift of faith, knowledge, and love of country. May we continuously give You thanks for every opportunity and become fruitful. May these three virtues, which symbolize our school, Fides, Sentia, and Patria, be manifested in our everyday life. We come to You not because we are worthy, but because we need You to face all the different challenges of these modern times. This we ask through Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Let us remain in attention as we pledge our allegiance to our beloved country through the singing of our Philippine National Anthem. You may now be seated. Education is one of the basic needs of our society to lead our country to success. It is a pride in my part that our beloved alma mater, the Guaguan National Colleges, religiously supports this need for education by the realization of its mission and vision. To serve our students' quality education is the main aim of this institution, and it envisions commitment to quality education with professional integrity to fully equip our students the necessary education they need. Along with that quality education is the ambition of our school to develop holistically our learners in three aspects. First, to mold their love and allegiance to our country. Second, to inculcate in them the value of knowledge and wisdom. And third and most important, to cultivate and nourish their faith to our almighty and powerful God. That's how we come up with the three virtues of our institution, which are represented by our muses. Patria, which is love for country, and it is characterized by the color red. Sensha, which is color green, is the search for truth and knowledge. And Fides for yellow, which means faith in God and oneself. With that, it's a privilege for us to have here today our three gorgeous and wholesome muses, which embody our three core virtues, Fides, Sensha, and Patria. Karating amanong areti, papakit na ing matibe ng pundasyon ning eskwela. Kareng dakal kapag subukan, linabas man ing gera, albugyaman, silabyaman, at maging king kasalukuyang sakit alalaganap, king nanumang panahon lumabas, makatikdoya pa rin ing GNC. Eya kumupas ing santing ning GNC. Manibat pa kanita ang gaman ngeni, patuloy ya pa rin mamayagpag ing bandera ning GNC. Pauli da rin kayang successful alumni, karing taong manimuno at karing taong magtiwala at lulugod king kekatamong eskwela. Kasalpantayanan king Diyos at king sarili, Fides, ing pamanintun king katotuan at kabiasnan, Sensya, at lugod king Balen, Patria. It is indeed GNC ala kang kupas. A house stands solid if it is rooted on the firm pillars and foundation. Though the goings at times may be rocky, it will never be swayed. It will never falter. Our house is the Guagui National Colleges, and the pillar that lends support to all of us is our school president. Without further ado, to set the mood and give us a preview of today's affair, Trustee Geraldine G. Lim, MBA, is here with us today. Let us now lend our ears as she welcomes us all here gathered in this ceremony. A resounding applause for her, please.
Thank you, Sir Allen. Our most esteemed guest, Dr. Sherwin Joseph P. Sarmiento. Our energetic Board of Administrators, supportive faculty, members of non-teaching staff, beloved students, guests, welcome. And a pleasant afternoon to all of you. Dr. Hill Francis S. Pelayo too. Thank you po, you made it. Before anything else, on behalf of the GNC community, I would like to first of all pay gratitude to the founder, Father Nicanor Banzali, and to the founder members of the school. For without these noble minds and their sincere efforts, we would not have been sitting here celebrating the 104th founding anniversary of our institution. Today is the initial day of commemorating the time when our school started its journey 103 years back. The GNC family has been witness for the school's struggle to become a pillar of knowledge year after year. It has been playing a leading role for the aspiring student community. The most important fundamental about our school is its mission, which is now being represented by the beautiful muses, viewed amazingly on the stage at this very moment. Miss Fides, representing the school's faith in God and oneself. Miss Sensha, the search for truth and knowledge, and Miss Patria, the love for our country. It has been successful in this mission all along the years, continuing providing all-round development of its stakeholders. On this occasion of the coronation night of our muses, I believe that this is also a very opportune moment to express deep gratitude to all our teachers who help our learners learn, not just the lessons from the books, but also qualities that make good human beings in variety of teaching platforms to address the present scenario in the academe due to the pandemic. Also to our administrators, who are our principals, heads, and deans, who untiringly sustain the academic needs of each and every recipient of education they serve. Their collaborative efforts successfully created talents in different parts of the society in different professional roles. The manners and opportunities that they provide help the students show and develop the hidden talents and skills they have, just like these gorgeous muses who are about to be crowned this evening. This is the reason why GNC has never been outshone by any obstacle that comes its way and continues its journey towards delivering quality education, honing with the call of times. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Executive Committee of the 104th GNC Founding Anniversary, our deepest appreciation for all those who made this event significant. Once again, good evening, God bless us all, and God bless the GNC. Thank you.
Thank you very much to Trustee Geraldine Gillem, our GNC President, for that message. It is with pride and honor to introduce our esteemed guests for this afternoon, who are equally prominent personalities in the field of medicine. They are no longer new to us, for they are both alumni of our beloved institution. Allow me to introduce them to you one by one. Our first guest, who will crown our beautiful ladies, is a fellow in the Philippine College of Physicians, a fellow in the Philippine College of Cardiology, and a fellow in the Philippine Society of Vascular Medicine. As for his education and training, he attended his elementary in 1983 to 1989 and graduated high school in 1989 to 1993 as class salutatorian here at Guaguan National Colleges. From 1993 to 1996, at the De La Salle University, he pursued his Bachelor of Science major in biology. He finished his Doctor of Medicine at Manila Central University in the year 2000. As for his residency training in internal medicine, he had it in 2002 to 2005 at Victor R. Potenciano Medical Center. For his fellowship training in cardiology, he took it in 2006 to 2009 at St. Luke's Medical Center, Quezon City Heart and Vascular Institute. And in the same institution, in the year 2010 to 2011, he had his clinical research fellowship training in vascular medicine. Among his positions and membership, he is a member of the European Society of Cardiology. He is a consultant in vascular medicine section at the Medical City, Clark, St. Luke's Medical Center, Quezon City, Pampanga Medical Specialist Hospital, Florida Blanca Doctors Hospital Incorporated, and at the Green City Medical Center. He is the head of the Vascular Medicine Division of the Cardiovascular Section, Department of Internal Medicine, Angeles University Foundation Medical Center from 2012 to present. He is the treasurer of the Pampanga Medical Society. He was the past president of the Philippine Heart Association Central Luzon Chapter from May 2013 to May 2015. And finally, he is the external vice president of the Philippine College of Physicians Central Luzon Chapter. Friends, it is my honor and great privilege to introduce to you the son of our former GNC President, Dr. Maria Lourdes S. Pelayo. Let us put our hands together to Dr. Hill Francis S. Pelayo.
Good afternoon, everyone. It's nice to be back here. Nice to see some familiar faces, new faces. My first time to be a guest of honor for this coronation night. And hindi naman nagbago yung mga magagandang binibini ng GNC. It's not unusual to see beautiful faces, pretty faces, no, representing our school. So without further ado, Madam President, Ma'am Geraldine Gozolim, the members of the Board of Trustees, the members of the Board of Administrators, and our Ma'am Merly Tarazon, he's the head of the... Okay. And to our previous teachers, to all the teaching and non-teaching personnel, to all the alumni, to all our online viewers, and lastly, to our muses, our Miss Patria, Miss Angela Shea S. Silvestre, our Miss Ciencia, Miss Aron Jazil S. De Leon, and our Miss Fides, Miss Eliza May M. Narvaja. Good afternoon, everyone. It's a lovely, fine afternoon. A little drizzling here and there. Yesterday was drizzling. Now, medyo makulimlim. What is the motto of GNC? They taught this to us as far back during elementary. Patria, Ciencia, Fides. Faith in God and oneself. Search for truth and knowledge and love of country. Again, Fides, Ciencia, and Patria in that order. So I'll start off with patria. What is patria? It comes from the Latin word pater, which means father. Patria is an etymology of pater, which means the fatherland, motherland, or the homeland. In broader terms, it means your country. So how does one show love for a country? There are lots of ways to express this. For young students like our Miss Patria, Miss Angela Shea S. Silvestre, one can show love of country by simply not throwing your trash just anywhere. You take your candy, you throw the wrapper in the trash bin, or you bring the wrapper with you and dispose of it once you go home. You keep your surroundings clean, and at the same time, you care for the environment. Or it can be as complex or as high as defending one's country in the event of an aggression like war. You can show your love of country by rising against an aggressor. If one is drafted in the army or in the military, you should heed the call of duty. Ciencia. So what is ciencia? Ciencia is the Latin word for knowledge. So how do we show our love for knowledge? For students like our Miss Ciencia, Aaron Jaziel S. De Leon, One can show their love of knowledge by simply studying well, focusing on their studies, avoiding falling absent in class, whether virtual or face-to-face, passing your exams, or better yet, passing them in flying colors. That's how you can show your love of knowledge. For adults, our love of knowledge can simply be shown by reading the news. Hindi po yung mga fake news, ha? Yung totoong news. Ha? And staying updated with latest information. For doctors like us, our next speaker, si Dr. Sherwin, no po. For doctors like us, we read peer-reviewed medical journals, we attend medical conventions to keep us abreast with the latest knowledge in our medical field of expertise. And lastly, for fides, what is fides? Fides is the Latin word for faith, trust, and fidelity. In broader terms, it means faith in God and oneself. So how do we show our faith in God and oneself? For students like our Miss Fides, Miss Eliza May M. Narvaja, one can show faith in God by hearing the words of God during days of obligation or even on regular days, trusting in God and living your everyday life in accordance with His will. You do good to others, you practice charity, you become honest to your fellow men. On the other hand, you can show faith to oneself by believing in yourself. If you have a dream, pursue it with vigor and enthusiasm. You don't let stumbling blocks hinder your dreams. Rise up to the challenge, pursue your goal. For the general public, quest for faith, truth, or fidelity can be shown by sticking to your convictions. Like, for example, if you are married, you become truthful or faithful to your partner, you stick with your partner through thick and thin. For the three lovely muses, they represent the core values of our alma mater. Our muses are our core values personified. Once you go out of the walls of our alma mater, bring the motto of our school with you. You breathe with them, you live with them. Again, faith in God and oneself, search for truth and knowledge, and love of country. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Hill Francis S. Pelayo. Our next guest is also a prominent figure in his chosen field. He is an alumnus of the GNC High School Batch 2002 and graduated as the batch first honorable mention. He is also the vice prefect and organist of the Sodality of Our Lady Choir. In 2006, he finished his medical technology course as cum laude at the University of Santo Tomas. In 2010, at the UST Faculty of Medicine and Surgery, he earned the merit benemeritus. He became the chief resident of the Department of Internal Medicine of the Armed Forces of the Philippines Medical Center in 2016, the chief public information officer of the AFP Health Service Command in 2018 to 2020. The past spokesperson of AFP to COVID Affairs from 2019 to 2020. A diplomat in internal medicine. And lastly, a fellow of the Philippine College of Physicians. Friends, ladies and gentlemen, help me in welcoming Dr. Sherwin Joseph P. Sarmiento. A big hand, please.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. I thought I was just going to play the piano while the muses are going to be crowned later on, but I will deliver an extemporaneous speech. I just trust the coaching Ma'am Rason gave me 20 years ago because I won extemporaneous speech under Ma'am Rason. So it's nice to be back. I told my mentors a while ago that I came unprepared. I did not prepare for a speech, but I told my previous teachers that I am going to talk from the heart. So, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon to our president, Ma'am Geraldine Lim, who happened to be my advisor when I was in fourth year high school, the members of the Board of Administration, especially Ma'am Relita Rason, and all the people under this service. I would like to recognize and would like to give a special mention to the teachers whom I know are still teaching during my batch up until now, Ma'am Rason, Ma'am Lim, Ma'am Mirna Miranda, my first year advisor, Ma'am Monette Manalo, and Sir Butch Gozun, who happened to be my patient, my COVID patient. So, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. I would like to use the first line of my valedictory speech when I was in elementary, that a million-mile journey begins with a step. 2002, I graduated first honorable mention from this institution, and that was, I considered, a small step in my lifelong journey to a successful doctor. So, GNC, I believe with the I would like to recognize also my senior in the medical profession, Dr. Pelayo. Sir, good afternoon. I believe that GNC molded me and prepared me to a bigger and brighter world ahead. Patria, Ciencia, Fides. GNC. God nurtures country. I just improvised the three letters of Guago National Colleges too. God nurtures country. The Philippines, being a Christian in a Catholic country, has never failed in its promise to the Lord to be of integrity in terms of politics, in terms of leadership, in terms of education, and daily professionalism. So that those are one of the basic virtues that the school has taught us. So nurturing, the quality education that this institution has given not only me, not only Dr. Pelayo, but the rest of all the alumni who graduated here are quality in terms of competence. We studied in Manila, and I was telling my teacher a while ago that during our college, during our med school, GNC was recognized because of our perseverance for excellence. And that virtue came from this institution. Love for country. We are going out of this institution after graduation. We will be landing our jobs, our dreams, our goals, but never forget what the institution has given us. It has given quality education. It has given a moral obligation to our country, to our fellow men. Sinasabi ko kanina, I am going to talk from the heart because I am emotional while I park a while ago because after 20 years, I graduated from this institution. It feels so good to be back. It feels so good to see familiar faces, but it also feels so good to see young generation of dreamers because 20 years ago, I was only a dreamer. Now, after 20 years, I am living the dream. Good afternoon. God bless us all.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sherman Joseph R.I.P. Sarmiento. And finally, we come to the main highlight of today's affair, and that is the coronation of our muses. To begin with, our Miss Patria 2022, Angela Shea Silvestre y Salvador. Our Miss Patria 2022 is Angela Shea Silvestre y Salvador. At present, she resides at Zone 6, Dila Dila, Santa Rita, Pampanga. She is the lovely daughter of Mr. Valmar S. Silvestre and Mrs. Marisa Salvador Silvestre. She celebrates her natal day every 28th of June. This 11-year-old girl enjoys dancing, singing, and playing the drums. For this God-given talents, she got an award as Best Drummer and Best in Hip-Hop Dance. The grade 5 pupil, Angela, belongs to the class of Mr. Michael A. Vergara, where she is a consistent honor pupil. In fact, she is a recipient of an Academic Excellence Award with honors. The purpose of having a family is to love them daily, is what our Miss Patria 2022 believes in. By means of this saying, she loves to travel and spend quality time with her family. Despite of the global pandemic that the world faces, she wanted to tell everyone that to be kind to one another, most especially in these trying times. Many people have not been able to see family and friends, and everyone has been subjected to stress and fear because of the pandemic. Never shy away from sharing a smile and doing good deeds, because it could make all the difference in someone's life. From the words of our Miss Patria, she really deserves her awards of being a peacemaker and a child with a heart of gold. As a Miss Patria 2022, Miss Silvestre takes the title as an inspiration to be a role model in loving our country. She can manifest patriotism by showing her gratitude to our soldiers and police officers. According to her, even as an 11-year-old, she valued the importance of respect, especially those who protect the peace and harmony in our land and communities. Aside from that, this proud young Filipina can express her loyalty to our country by being a role model to her fellow youth in taking pride in our national anthem and flag. She is so blessed wearing the beautiful crown and carry the title. For her, this entails a lot of responsibilities. Her heart is full of happiness from her family and friends because they bring out the best in her, especially her confidence. Our Miss Patria is a firm believer of God, who is her strength, a giver of hope and blessings. Once again, our 2022 Miss Patria, Angela Shea Silvestre y Salvador. On the center stage, please. Miss Patria 2022 will be crowned by her predecessor, Robin Summer Shania F. Suleiman, to be assisted by Trustee Geraldine Gillim, MBA, our school president, together with Dr. Sherwin Joseph P. Sarmiento and Dr. Hill Francis S. Pelayo. once again our 2022 Miss Patria, Angela Shea Silvestre y Salvador. To serenade the pulchritude of the fair Miss Patria 2022, please welcome Miss Ara Jane Albacani, faculty from the Singer High School program. Once again, to serenade the pulchritude of the fair Miss Patria 2022, please welcome Miss Ara Jane Albacani, faculty from the Singer High School regular program.
This celebrating in the moment. As I look around, I can't believe the love I see. My fears behind me, gone are the shadows, and now was them. This is my night. As I look around, I can't believe the love I see. My fears behind me, gone are the shadows, and now was them. This is my.
Thank you, Ms. Arizane L. Bacani, faculty from the Senior High School Regular Program. Ms. Shensha 2022, Aaron Jazil De Leon E. Swing. Last February 1, 2022, she was able to beat three other candidates and emerge as the Miss Shensha 2022. And she is Aaron Jazil De Leon E. Swing. This 16-year-old last hails at San Pedro Sasuan, Pampanga, with her proud parents, Mr. Arvin V. De Leon and Mrs. Joy Marie Swing De Leon. April 6, 2005 was the date when her mother gave birth to her. Jazz, often called by her classmates from grade 10 King David, with her advisor, Mrs. Shirley Magat Puso, loves singing, dancing, and modeling. Considering her sophisticated beauty, she joined Leguan in Sasuan 2021 and one of the top 10 finalists. Aaron Jazil was also a top academic achiever, a recipient of an Academic Excellence Award in her 7th grade as with honors. To be crowned as Miss Shensha is beyond her expectation. She is taken by pride and grace to hold the title, for she upholds the virtues and attributes to win the crown. This life-changing experiences gave her learning-filled memories. For her, pageant is not all about winning and wearing the crown, but it is on what you do after, your words and your actions. As a Miss Shensha, she will use this as a platform to inspire and to motivate her fellow students to focus on their dreams and to enhance their full potentials to be at their best version. She wants to conquer the world with great wisdom and knowledge, and she will never stop searching for nothing but the truth. It may be different from what we used to, but for her, being crowned as a Miss Shensha is a blessing. With this title, she will enhance the school's reputation by means of discipline towards herself. She will consider her title as access to improve and to maintain the success of the institution. She wants to extend her utmost gratitude to her parents and family for their constant love and support and for helping in reaching her dreams. Her sincerest appreciation and thank you is also given to Ate Maya, her friends and relatives for guiding and boosting her confidence throughout this journey. To her junior high school teachers, she wants to thank them for all the academic and real life lessons that they have imparted. My dear friends, Aaron Jazil De Leon E. Swing, our 2022 Miss Shensha, saying knowledge is your true power and will help you walk through life. Miss Shensha 2021 will be crowned by our Miss Shensha 2022 will be crowned by our previous Miss Shensha, Kimberly Nicole S. Torres. To be assisted, of course, by Trustee Geraldine GLM MBA, our school president, and of course, our guests, Dr. Sherwin Joseph P. Sarmiento and Dr. Hill Francis S. Pelayo. Once again, our Miss Shensha 2022, Aaron Jezel De Leon E. Swing. Abigan, please. Thank you, Mom and Sir. Join me as I welcome on stage Mr. Peter Ray D.M. Yop as he serenades our 2022 Miss Shensha. He deserves an echoing applause.
Wala gayon kailanman ikaw ang lahat ng aking galaw, ang sanhi ay ikaw. Ang mahalin ay ikaw. Sandali ay upang ulit muli ay ang mahalin ay ikaw. Thank
you very much, Mr. Peter Ray D.M. Yop from the Senior High School Regular Program. Miss Fides 2022, Alisa May Narvaja E. Manalang. The embodiment of faith in God is Miss Fides 2022. Is none other than Alisa May Narvaja E. Manala. Her abode is at San Juan First, Guagua, Pampanga. In the year 2001, 7th day of January, a princess was born in the person of our Miss Fides. She grew up in the loving hands of her parents, namely Mr. Ramon L. Narvaja and Mrs. Annalyn Manalang Narvaja. At this point of her life, she is a third-year student taking up Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering. She usually spends her pastime by watching movies, playing volleyball, and surfing the net. Because of her determination and passion to achieve her goals in life, this 21-year-old woman is a consistent honor from grade 7 to grade 12 and a grantee of scholarship in college. At this point, she wants to express her gratitude to her dean, Engineer Maria Lidja P. Sagdalan, for always being there and believing that she can do. To her friends, BSCE3, family, thank you to all your support. Special thanks is also extended to her parents and family for making her realize that she's worth everything in this world, that she must be treated like a queen, and for always telling her that never settle for less than what she deserves. Being Miss Fides, Alisa May promises to be a good role model to her fellow students in order to continuously be God's instrument, inspiring faith even in her acts. As a Miss Fides, it carries with a great responsibility. To be the Miss Fides 2022, she will promote faith in God by spreading the word of God, share the love, and be humble at all times. She will put emphasis on the importance of having faith in God in oneself, as her title suggests, through her actions. She wants to emphasize the value of professing one's faith, and she wants to start it to herself. She will do that by living and preaching God's words, lending a hand to those who need help, and showing kindness. It knows no religion raised boundaries, just like how our Almighty Father loves us. With that, she could live the ideals of our alma mater as the Miss Fides 2022. She wants to live as words to ponder, and I quote, "For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also." End of quote. Our 2022 Miss Fides, Alaisa May Narvaja y Manala. Miss Fides will be crowned by Genero Z. Papio, our Miss Fides 2021. Of course, to be assisted by our school president, Trustee Geraldine Gillem, and of course, our guests, Dr. Pelayo and Dr. Sarmiento. Our Miss Fides 2022, Alaisa May Narvaja y Manala. We are pleased to have a student from the College of Accountancy, Ms. Jenkal Tritzi O. Bautista, to serenade our Miss Fides 2022. A warm round of applause for her, please.
Nahulog din, di ko alam kung anong gagawin.
saan titingin, halik sa labi, tinginan natin, di akalain mahulog ka sakin. Tumingin ka sakin mga mata, hindi mo na kailangan pa matanong ng paulit-ulit, ikaw lang ang iniibig. Kung di kumbinsido'y magtiwala ka, hawakan ang puso't maniwala na, ikaw lang ang siyang inibig, ikaw lang ang ibigin. Sinta ng araw, akala'y di ko mahal. At ang nadarama ay hindi magpapagal. Mali ko ba hindi magpapagal? Iibigin kita kahit gaano pa katagal. Tanong ng paulit-ulit, ikaw lang iniibig. Hindi kumbinsido'y magtiwala ka, hawakan ang puso't maniwala na, ikaw lang ang siyang inibig, ikaw lang ang ibigin. La 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 la. La 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 la.
Thank you very much, Ms. Jinkal Tritsi Obautista from the College of Accountancy. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We have crowned our new muses for this academic year. Of course, it is in line with the celebration of our 104th founding anniversary. Let's give a warm round of applause once again to our Miss Patria, Miss Shensha, and Miss Fides for this academic year. At this juncture, as a sign of appreciation and gratitude as well, let's now award the Certificate of Appreciation to our guests. May I invite our school president, Trustee Geraldine J. Lim, MBA, to be assisted by the chairwoman of the working committee and the head of the instruction cluster, Dr. Merlita C. Rizon, to come up on stage. As the certificate reads, Guaguan National Colleges Incorporated, Guagua, Pampanga, founded 1918. Certificate of Appreciation is hereby presented to Dr. Hill Francis S. Palayo, the class salutatorian of High School Batch 1993, in grateful recognition of his esteemed presence as guest of honor during the coronation night held at the Guagua National Colleges Incorporated Auditorium on the occasion of the school's 104th Foundation Anniversary Celebration. Given this 23rd day of February 2022 at the Guagua National Colleges Incorporated, Guagua, Pampanga. Signed, Dr. Merlita C. Rizon, the chairwoman on the Working Committee for the Board of Administrators for the 104th Foundation Anniversary Celebration, and of course, the overall chairman and our president of the school, Trustee Geraldine G. Lim. Let's clap our hands to Dr. Francis S. Pelayo. another certificate will be awarded. Certificate of appreciation is hereby presented to Dr. Sherwin Joseph P. Sarmiento, the first honorable mention in the high school batch 2002 and the vice prefect of the sodality of Our Lady Choir. Of course, this is signed by Dr. Merlita C. Rizan and our school president, Trustee Geraldine G. Lim. Thank you very much. We would also like to express our gratitude to the Silver Jubilarians High School Batch 1997, Counselor Mario Maliari and Mr. Benjamin Lim for their donation that they have given to us. Thank you very much, po. And that ends the main highlight of our 104th GNC founding anniversary celebration. As we close another successful affair, may we bring and inculcate forever in our minds the dreams of our GNC founder, Father Nicanor Banzali. His desires, first, to inculcate patriotism in our hearts to become productive member of our society, to yearn for wisdom for our learners as we help them to grow and mold their cognitive aspect, and above all, never forget to acknowledge our God, that we may forge firm and ceaseless faith to Him, Fides, Sensha, and Patria. In behalf of the GNC Board of Administrators and the GNC family, we would like to thank all of you for watching from the different official websites, from the different departments, and to everyone who graced our occasion. We have witnessed the elegance and beauty of our muses, inspired by the thoughts given by our guests, Dr. Sherwin Joseph P. Sarmiento and Dr. Hill Francis S. Pelayo, and listened to the charismatic and amazing voices of our faculty and students. To formally end this special night, let us all stand and sing the GNC hymn. Again, this has been Mr. Alinjan S. Nulut saying thank you and God bless us all. we may take this opportunity to take a photo with our three muses.
And I can tell you that GNC does not lose its integrity.
GNC gave me a vision. GNC gave me that inspiration. And GNC gave me that confidence to be an effective leader.
I do believe that this is the best, if not one of the best schools here in Guagua.
GNC is really committed on providing quality education to its students because I am a living witness to that because I experienced quality education inside the four walls of GNC.
Isa sa mga natutunan ko is to become excellent as always. Sometimes sabi nila yung pagiging competitive negative eh. Pero isa ito sa mga binigay na spirit ng GNC sa akin. To be competitive, to be excellent in all things that you can do, no?
Tingin ko, bakit ako magtagal sa GNC? It's probably I really love the profession. I became who I am now, it's because of GNC. It has given me a lot of opportunities.
Sila yung nagbigay motivasyon sa akin. Sa kanila din ako kumuha ng inspirasyon kung bakit ako naging guru ngayon, yung profession ko ngayon. Na nagagamit ko nung nakita ko sa kanila yung kanilang pagmamahal sa trabaho, yung dedikasyon. na nagamit ko ngayon sa pagiging guro ko.
Nagtagal ako sa GMC, labat ako ng 28 years kasi nakita ko doon na marami akong bagay na pwedeng matutunan.
My dear friends, many people will be claiming that the heydays of GNC are gone. Wala na daw. But always remember, and please tell them, as the song goes, the best is yet to come.
Pinandaman ko yung eskwela ngayon, itang uling stable yun, respectable yung eskwela. Kaya talaga ngayon ako may gandong isip, actually, linawe, aliwa pang eskwelang kini may pag-aaral naman anya niya na ako talagang mega dualo.
Ing abalo ko kay GNC, yapening Lugod King School, yapening second home ni. Kasi kay ni ko many batan, kay ni ko megong pisa, ampong kay ni ko ikuha kong nano man ing atin ko ampong nano kong ngayon.
Sana isundo na rin karing tutuki pang mag-aral in hanggang pamanurong aturo na rin kaya kami.
GNC has always been my home, my alma mater since my elementary years. Now, I've been working at GNC for the past 32 years, and I wasn't only an alumna and an employee, but I was also a parent since my two children pursued their education here at GNC. Throughout my stay here, I have seen it through all the years that it stood still. Masakit man, darakalman ng pagdalanan, talakad at talakad yung GNC. Not only for its students, but also for the employees that it shelters. Makanya niya kalugod in GNC. For the last 103 years, it stayed committed in providing affordable and quality education. And now that GNC is on its 104th founding year, not even the pandemic can stop it from thriving, from standing still. True to our theme this year, ala ka talagang kupas, GNC, na numang panahon in lumaban.